The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, Almighty God, that we who for our evil deeds do worthily deserve to be punished, by the comfort of thy grace may mercifully be relieved through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who hatest nothing that thou hast made, and dost forgive the sins of all those who are penitent, create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of thee, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Defend us, O Lord, we beseech thee, from all dangers, both of body and soul. And at the intercession of the blessed and glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of blessed Joseph, of thy holy apostles Peter and Paul, and of all thy saints, grant us thy saving health and peace, that being defended from all adversities and all false doctrines, thy church may serve thee in freedom and quietness, through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the fourth chapter of the letter to the Galatians, beginning with the 21st verse. Tell me, ye that desire to be under the law, do ye not hear the law? For it is written that Abraham had two sons, the one by a bondmaid and the other by a free woman. But he who was of the bondwoman was born after the flesh, but he of the free woman was by promise. Which things are an allegory? For these are two covenants, the one from Mount Sinai, which gendereth to bondage, which is Agar. For this Agar is Mount Sinai in Arabia, and answereth to Jerusalem, which now is and is in bondage with her children. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free, and which is the mother of all of us. For it is written, rejoice, thou barren and bearest not. Free, break forth and cry, thou travailest not. For the desolate hath many more children than she which hath an husband. Now we, brethren, as Isaac was, are the children of promise. But as then he was born after the flesh, persecuted him that was born after the Spirit, even so it is now. Nevertheless, what saith the Scripture? Cast out the bondwoman and her son, for the son of the bondwoman shall not be heir with the son of the free woman. So then, brethren, we are not children of the bondwoman, but of the free. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the sixth chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias, and a great multitude followed him, because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. And Jesus went up into a mountain, and there he sat with his disciples. And the Passover, a feast of the Jews, was nigh. When Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he saith unto Philip, Whence shall we buy bread that these may eat? And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 pennyworth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, saith unto him, There is a lad here which hath 5 barley loaves and 2 small fishes, but what are they among so many? And Jesus said, Make the men sit down. Now there was much grass in the place, so the men sat down, in number about 5,000. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes as much as they would. When they were filled, he said unto his disciples, Gather up the fragments that remain, that nothing be lost. Therefore they gathered them together and filled 12 baskets with the fragments of the 5 barley loaves, which remained over and above unto them that had eaten. Then those men, when they had seen the miracle that Jesus did, said, This is of a truth that prophet that should come into the world.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Throughout this most holy season of Lent, we have examined, mulled over a lot of and a variety of subjects. We've looked at temptation, incarnation, we've looked at self-examination, and all the rest. And today we examine two things. Number one is punishment, and number two, grace. We begin with the collect, and when you heard the collect, hopefully you heard those two words, punishment and grace. And remember the pithy truth of the faith that says that we pray what we believe and then we believe what we pray? It's true. If we have prayed something, we believe it. Maybe at portions of time in your life you don't quite believe it, but that's the goal. The goal is to believe what we pray, most assuredly. Today we slap ourselves in the face then while admitting that we deserve at times to be punished. Well, some might say, and they're probably people who are not within the faith, but some might say when they heard that, well now, wait a minute, you prayed that, I didn't. It was kind of like I'm crossing my fingers and I get a free pass. Well, that's not true. Now, let me tell you an example of this. It's called the church's mission. Why do we exist? Why did all of this happen? The church's mission, I'll tell you what the church's mission, first of all, is not. The church's mission is not to change with the manipulations of societal ascension. We don't care about what society thinks is good. That's the church's temptation. And sadly, oftentimes the church caves in. Rather, the church's mission is to preach the gospel message, to bring salvation to people, and therefore change the manipulations of societal standards. We humans need to then subsequently change our life so as to be truly and fully and happily God's adopted children. Whether or not you like the sound of the word punishment, doesn't matter, it's true to the human condition, most assuredly. And now the church is attempting to teach the faith of Christ Jesus. That's our mission as Christians. Historically, however, that teaching the faith of Jesus, it's been off and on, you know, always a rough journey at times. And most assuredly, we live in a time when not all denominations with the moniker Christian have remained faithful. But God's church, God's true church, must remain faithful. What is our tendency? To do what we want to do, not what God would have us do. And for that, we deserve to be punished. In fact, we do punish ourselves in a variety of ways. Therefore, we need to change to become immersed in his love, and then subsequently then, because we love him so much, that we live life accordingly. So that's punishment. Let's look to the next one. That brings us to the second subject, grace. What is that? Grace is God working in us. The holy making the unholy more holy. God sanctifying all of creation. Let me give you an example of that. Today's gospel. Jesus made something out of nothing. He had a bunch of people who were hungry. There wasn't enough food. The hand of God then subsequently intervened, and people were fed. Grace-filled and miraculous experience, is it not? Yes. Now, we can relate to that because we have the miraculous also in our individual lives. All you need to do is think about those, dig up those times when you knew that God's presence was within you. Those are the miraculous times that we all have. But we also have powerful miraculous times in our parish of St. Luke's Church. It was created through the grace-filled presence and guidance of God, the Holy Spirit. And through his presence and guidance and strengthening, the land was secured years ago and the property was paid off and the church was built. And the parish continued through extraordinarily difficult times, to be sure, and we'll probably get some more of those sometime down the road. But one generation to the next, even to this gathering here today, we are blessed by God's grace. You see, St. Luke's transcends time. What do I mean by that? When we are no longer here, perhaps, help us, Lord, singing in his choir. This church will still be powerful and do his ministry to the fastest and the best. One generation to another, it just goes on and on and on. But left to our own devices, blocking God out of our life, without the Holy Spirit, we know we could not have succeeded in what has occurred through this parish's ministry. Why? Because we are but earthen pots, cracked, leaky, fragile, and sometimes even empty. And yet, because of his grace, nothing will stop us. Nothing will stop his words from being preached, received, shared, lived, embraced. Nothing will stop us until his coming again. Now let's bring this down home and into Sedona. You remember the rains from this past week? Pretty tough in some places in Sedona and all of the Verde Valley. But there's an allegory for us. There's an allegory for our walk in this world. You know, one of my favorite psalms is Psalm 69. I think you all have said this, hopefully you have. Save me, O God, for the waters are come in even unto my soul. I stick fast in the deep mire where no ground is. I am come into deep waters. That's kind of like what happened in this area this past week. But it is an allegory. It's impossible to walk as God's people unless we have his Spirit within us. There are things that we have done that we should not have done. And there are things that we've not done that we need to do. Punishment is not inevitable. God's grace is sufficient. Just ask him for help. When his grace is given, and it will be if you ask, you will grow and be enabled to do all things for his greater glory.
All things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own have we given thee.
Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice in thanksgiving unto Almighty God for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable unto God the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive this sacrifice in thine hand, the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, and especially our Bishop David, and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy way, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, because that by our bodily fasting thou dost curb our sinfulness, dost raise our minds from things of earth, dost renew our strength and reward us with manifold blessings through Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy,
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 Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of thy glory.
Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High.
Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, thy tender mercy, didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils past, present, and to come, and at the intercession of all thy saints, give peace graciously in our days, that we, being holpen by the succor of thy mercy, may both always be free from sin and safe from all disquietude, through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to thine apostles, peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Regard not my sins, but the faith of thy church, and grant thee that peace in me, which is according to thy will. Who liveth and reigneth, God, the world without end. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
O Lord, receive the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for me, preserve my body and soul to everlasting life. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for you, preserve thy body and soul into everlasting life. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Eat and drink this in remembrance of Christ's blood was shed.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.